see you on this Christmas Eve.
Yes, it's good to be seen.
It's good to be seen. Yes. Did anybody pray for snow this Christmas? Your prayers are answered. You are good. That's really fine. And a good snow this morning, and we've got it all covered. Well, I am so glad that you are here. I am Joe D. Dowling Soka, one of the pastors here. Christina is the other, and she's sitting right over here and will be up here preaching today. Well, let's just start by doing one thing, asking you to do one thing. Think of something that you're going to do tomorrow that you're looking forward to. One thing that you're looking forward to doing tomorrow. One thing. And if you can have it be one word, that would even be better. But not all of us would do that. Okay, you got it? Everybody got it? Turn to somebody and tell them that one thing. One thing you're looking forward to doing tomorrow.
Sleeping in.
Yeah. It was more than one word, wasn't it? Yes. All right. All right. Well, a couple of housekeeping things. Well, let us get in an attitude of worship.
Joyful and triumphant.
Christmas, the good news came to shepherds in the field, keeping watch over the flocks by night.
We have heard the call to keep watch, but what are we keeping watch over?
Maybe we're looking for something that will define us, something that will remake us, transform us, some relationship, some hope, some love that will make us new. What we go out to see in the muddle of our world is not necessarily the Christ child or the light that glows within. No, I think what we watch over is the world that he came to save, the masses of humanity who think they can find salvation in the stuff of this life, like we know we do sometimes, when we forget. A world that has room for a savior, even when we've forgotten it.
Maybe we're looking for the gift we remember this night. And part of what we're keeping watch for is to see whether we can make room. Room for grace, room for joy, room for peace, even at our worst, at our most needy, and most helpful, and grace-filled.
Keep watch. Let us complete this circle as we rejoice in the light that shines in the darkness. Tonight, we light the Christ candle in the center of our wreath.
May we put
Christ in the center of our lives and the center of our world this night.
Birthday candles for the King. Let the alleluias ring. Let us rejoice.
Thank you.
couple of verses.
Are we having a children's sermon first?
Oh, are we going to do a children's sermon?
Yes, we are.
Oh, Christina. I think I might have jumped us ahead.
At this time, if you are a little person who would like to, or a bigger person who would like to come up for our children's lesson, I want to have you help me put the manger scene together. So we need a hoop.
Thank you.
Emmanuel, God with us, most of all tonight. Your light lifts up our hearts, our spirits, and our voices. We give you thanks for your birth long ago and your presence with us always. Your hope is more trustworthy than our promises. Your peace is deeper than our prayers. Your joy teaches us to sing even when we want to cry. Your love is wider than the chorus of the galaxies. And yet your star shines on us now in this church, which has become a manger. Amen.
Chapter 2, beginning with the first verse. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
While shepherds watched their flocks, living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." The first Noel.
Shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
What child is this? Verses 1 and 2.
Child is this who came to rest on Mary. this verse. When we can come to the manger and say, here I am, Lord. The greatest gift that we can give to God is the gift of ourselves. For many years, we would travel down to Florida when we were pastors in Iowa. Our parents then living were down in Florida. It'd be a snowy, snowy night. It'd be a long night's journey. We would drive through the night. The kids would be in their car seats. We would hope and pray that they would sleep through the night. And all the way, Joseph Everett Dowling Sobey would play his music. Soulful ballads, Bruce Coburn, and he especially loved Leonard Cohen. Not exactly your normal Christmas music. I said, Jody, how about a little bit of laughter and delight? And maybe a little while later we could get him to switch over to the carols. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Oh, holy night, if the truth be told, we needed both kinds of songs, both the joy and the ones that touch our deepest needs. You remember that song from Leonard Cohen? Ring the bells. Forget your perfect offering. There is a crack in everything. That's how the light gets in. If the truth be told, we are all a little cracked, a little broken, a little weary, a little worn. And yet the good news is that God can take the pieces of our lives and weld us back together. Again, the good news is that nothing can separate us from the love of God. Each year I focus on something different. Some 1 year it's the angels, 1 year I don't know what it is, but this year it's the Christmas
tree. I got this tree after risking my life to go to Palmer Fellowship this morning. This is what I have to show for it. And it's a beautiful tree. The spouse of Pastor Donna there makes an ornament each year, and he takes his drill and he makes these beautiful little ornaments. But I was thinking about Christmas trees. And you know that story about little Charlie Brown Christmas tree with the little ball that goes over. A lot of our trees were like that growing up. Over the years, we've had a wonderful pen pal. Her name is Miss Bernice. And she in New York has written letter after letter after letter to our children. And she shared this book this year, Why Christmas Trees Aren't Perfect. And she said that if you read the story, the story goes that they used to think they all had to be perfect because they were going to be chosen by the queen. The best tree would be chosen and have a place of high honor. And yet there was one little tree that grew up starting to look very, very perfect. And it was proud of how it was looking. Every branch was in place. And then love happened. One day, a little rabbit was being chased by some dogs. And the tree saw this happening, and the tree was scared for the little rabbit. And as the rabbit came close, the tree bent its branches over the rabbit and hit it. And the rabbit was saved. And yet, when the rabbit went on, scampering safely back home, the branches were forever shaped down around. That way was no longer a perfect tree. Well, then one day, a little bird came by. And it was very, very cold, and the little bird came, and the little bird needed a place to be, and all the other perfect trees wouldn't let the bird rest in its branches. But this little tree let love happen, and this little tree gathered that bird in and made a little nest, and it stayed there for a while. And yet when the bird flew off a few weeks later, well, I couldn't say to that one. But it went off. There was this little bit. The tree was no longer a perfect tree. Well, then, there was a little deer that came walking through the woods, and the snows were deep, and the other trees, the perfect trees, wouldn't let the little deer eat and live from the branches. But love happened, and this little tree shared its branches. Well, after all this love, the little tree didn't look very perfect,
anymore. And yet, when the queen came through looking for the tree at first, she almost said, oh my goodness, how did that tree land in my forest? We need to chop it down. But then she looked closer and she saw the little bunny prints and she saw little bits of feathers and she recognized where a deer would eat from those branches. And then, my bad at this part of the story, she did not chop it down. She took a shovel and she went all the way around it. And she carefully carried that tree. And it was the most beautiful tree. And I tell this story because my prayer is that we will know that we do not have to be perfect. The story of Christmas is a story of a God who focused himself into human form and came that we might have life. And he gathers us in with all our imperfections. And he loves us just as we are. And tonight we will share the light and we'll go from one to one to one to one. I used to be a camp director in the mountains of Tennessee, and we would have little children all the way from second graders up to 12th graders. And every Thursday night we pretended it was like Christmas Eve. We would have our candle lighting. And you had to give the safety speech to the children. So I'm going to give it to you now. If your candle is unlit, if it's lit, leave it standing straight up. And if it's unlit, you bring it over. And I love watching the light go. We're going to spread the light in a little bit. I love watching the light go from person to person to person. Because that's the good news of Christmas, that we've got a God who is greater than we can possibly imagine, who's going to be with us no matter what. He will not forsake us. And his light can shine in your life. Well, around that campfire, the winds would often blow. And sometimes a candle would go out. And sometimes, particularly the little second graders, really didn't know how to hold their candle. But it was so beautiful, the 12th graders would come along and they would light that candle that went unlit. They would help the little ones along. And my prayer is that you will know that you are not alone, that you are always welcome in God's home. You are always welcome here. And my prayer is that you will know that Jesus loves you, and with his light, together, we may shine. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks that we can come just as we are to you at Christmas. And in the hurry and the rush, sometimes it's hard to remember how much you do love us. So we come, and the greatest gift that we can give you this year is the gift of our hearts. And maybe we have journeyed down the wrong roads and we're going in the wrong direction. And the snows are deep. And you call us to come home. And if we hear your voice, we hear you say, welcome home, my child. And you shelter us. When we feel as though everything is chasing us, you give us a nest of your grace. And you sustain us. In our spirits. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us today. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us, we pray. Amen.
When I was a child, this was the most magical moment. And it still is. I guess I'm still a child. Don't say anything about that. So I think what Christina was trying to help us understand is that if your candle is lit, then you hold it like this. And if you're lighting it, then of course you come in sideways like this. And we pass it one to another. And what's going to be fun is we're going to see the lights as they are out. We're going to see the room get brighter. And one of the things you'll notice is that we all look better in candlelight.
Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not and will not overcome.
Joy to the world, would you stand and let's sing. One, two, three.